mornings to all of you. Now this lectures related to unit numbers 1's important questions to be asked in our exams. So let us consider the first point in this unit. Related to this, questions will be like this way: what is industrial engineering? Explains in brief about industrial engineering. Now we know that industrial engineering is a proficiency that is concerned with complex process systems, the methods and improvements in the existing methods. So this definition is about the industrial engineering, and the main objective of industrial engineering, that is to increase the production, productivity and reduce the cost, improvement in the existing methods, reduce the downtimes, the process having more times, that we reduced, calculate the standard times, and effective use of the all resources. So these are the objective of the industrial engineering. So with help of these points, you explain the answer of these questions in brief. Now questions number 2, what is the concept of industrial engineering? Explains in brief about contribution of F.W. Taylor's and F.B. Gilbert in the development of industrial engineering. Now this industrial engineering is a proficiency that is concerned with all methods, systems, the existing complex problems in the industry, systems, and study about this process and improvement in this process. This is about the industrial engineering. And what is the actual contributions of the F.W. Taylor's and F.B. Gilbert? So F.W. Taylor's, that is related to methods in which way the components will going to manufactures. Number of methods are there. In one of the video lectures we have seen forging methods, means convert the raw materials into finished product. So many steps are there in methods, and how to reduce the downtimes, the wastage of the materials, proper manpowers. So related questions we have already discussed. So F.W. Taylor's, in the development of industrial engineering, he has given more concentrations on the methods. Means he is the father of method study. He studied about the methods and which is the effective methods for manufacturing by reducing downtimes, wastage and increase the production and productivity. So this type of contributions it is given by the F.W. Taylor's. Now the F.B. Gilbert, what is his shares in the development of industrial engineering? Now he studied about the different types of motions, maybe micro motions, and which motions that is effectively, and in which way the component will going to manufactures. So unnecessary motions will going to reduce, study about the each and every motion and how to reduce the times required to complete the given task. So this type of contribution it is given by F.W. Gilbert. Now question number 3, explain in brief about production and productivity, list factors affecting on productivity. So productions means the quantity to be manufactured within the specified times, that is absolute terms volume should be there. And here within the shift, how many quantity need to be produced as per the plannings. So these are the part of production. Now this productivity, that is the related terms, that is the relations between output, upon input. So it is expected there should be constant input with more output, or we can reduce the input, automatically the output should be less. So this type of productivity and production concept is there. Now related to this, which factors will going to affect on this productivity? So there are actually two types are there. One is the controllables or the internal factors. Internal factors means within the organizations, and external factor, that is the uncontrollable factors. So let us consider our controllable factors. In that, product is there, then the plant equipment should be there, technology will be there, material should be there, manpower should be there, working method should be there, and management styles and financial factors. So these are the internal factors definitely affect on the productivity. External factors, it contain infrastructure, government policy about taxes, transportation, communications, and the economical and social things. It is very important factors which will affect on the productivity. Now next question is there, which factors will helpful for improvement in the productivity? So there are so many factors are there. So first factors for improvement in the productivity is the technology based. If a good technology is there, for example CNC, VNC, CAD CAM, flexible manufacturing system is there, they will get good accuracy and more production, less rejection will be there. This is the one factors related to productivity improvement. Next factor is that employee based. The employee based means personal development should be there, incentive, motivational things should be there, job rotations should be there. Now worker need to participate in the management policy, quality circles should be there. So this is the employee based point. Then next, that is the material based one. In this inventory control, that is very important. Material requirement planning should be there, less wastage should be there, if possible reuse of that material should be there. Then process based point. In this improved method, improved process should be there. There should be job simplification, safety should be there, and also the some human factor also affect on the process based. Product based means in the market too many products are there, but because of the increasing manufacturing cost, our product cost will get increased. So we have to think how to reduce this product by using value engineering technique, then by using product mix, promotion, simplification, standardization, diversification, then reliability and quality. So this point need to be considered under product based. And last point is management based. If good management style of the working is there, definitely productivity will get increased. Good communications between the supervisor, workers and top management. Good working culture should be there. Motivational things will be there. Promoting for group activities should be there. Working environmental, this also will affect on the improvement in the productivity. Next thing is that, what is the difference between work study and method study? Now work study, this is related to a job, and to reduce the cost of the manufacturing, reduce the downtimes, and improve the production and productivity. So method study is that, the in which way the jobs will going to manufactures. So one jobs, there are so many methods are there. So out of this, which methods that is useful for doing a job means right methods, right person, right materials, right the technology. If you use, then there is the right production and productivity should be there. So this is the basic point difference related to work study and method study. Already in additional notes I have given this point in a brief. Now next next question is there, what is the work study, what are the objective of work study? So work study, that is very very important from the industrial engineering point of view. Now work study on which number of points are there, that is the work measurement and method study. If we define this work study, it is a generic terms, and for this some technique has been used, that is the method study and work measurements, which will examine the present methods of human's work and systematically study about the present methods and finding the best way of the doing the method in order to improve the productivity. And what are the objectives? Same objectives are there. What actually we have discussed related to industrial engineering. The production, productivity, cost, and all these things should be there. Now, next questions related to this chapter number one. What do you know about work simplification and human factors with work study? Now, simplifications means easy way for doing a job. Easy way for doing job. Any critical job is there, then we will think how to manufacture that job by easy way. In simple way, it is analysis and details evaluation of the product. Again, there should be less wastage, unnecessary times, activity that we have to reduce, cost of manufacturing that is also be reduced. Now, humans factors in the work study, there should be good relationship between managers, supervisors, employees. Due consideration should be given to everyone and concerned as an individual, and should see that no more threatened to his security. Means there should be good relationship between management, supervisor and worker. Definitely there is the effect on the production and productivity. So this is about the today's lectures related to the important questions to be asked in the university exams.